Transport Services Minister Chloe Fox has again come under attack for mishandling her portfolio. A government audit finding one bus provider running regularly late, leaving one in five passengers stranded for at least 10 minutes.
A long wait commuters know only too well. New figures revealing as many as 40% of our buses regularly run late.
Really, complete non-compliance exposed now.
A three-month government audit of the state's largest provider, Transfield Services, found 40% failed to keep to the timetable in the northern and southern suburbs. 20% were behind by more than 10 minutes or never showed up. The minister fined Transfield just $14,000 for its tardiness.
At the moment, that penalty, given the number of trips, is a few dollars per trip.
Today the minister conceded the fine was on the lower end of the scale.
If there has been no improvement, clearly that fine can go up.
She also justified the delays, saying buses were at the mercy of traffic congestion and roadworks. The opposition calling for a return to her predecessor, Patrick Conlon.
She's asleep at the wheel on this issue, and I never thought I'd say it, but bring back Pat.
Passengers have a clear message for the minister.
Bad, the buses, really bad. This morning we waited nearly half an hour on Hawker Street there. They're getting worse and worse.
Sometimes they don't even come at all, especially the express ones.
It can be very frustrating on a hot day and you've got to stand in the sun, there's no shelter.
It's not a performance that is good enough, and it's certainly a performance that we would be seeking to improve.
Adam Todd, 10 News.
And the attack on the Transport Services Minister has exploded this afternoon. Political reporter Adam Todd joins us live from Parliament House. Adam, question time, turn grubby.
That's right, Beck. While Chloe Fox was answering a question in Parliament this afternoon, Liberal MP Michael Pengelly yelled across the chamber, "You ought to be put down." Now, Mr. Pengelly is a repeat offender. He was the MP who called Prime Minister Julia Gillard a real dog on Twitter, sparking national outrage. Now, Chloe Fox immediately demanded an apology, saying female MPs shouldn't have to put up with these sexist taunts from Mr. Pengelly. He did apologise to the chamber, and Liberal leader Isabel Redmond says that's good enough for her. But given he is a repeat offender, there is a feeling an apology this time just won't cut it. Here's how the exchange unfolded.
I knew they wouldn't like it, Madam Speaker.
Order! The member for Finnis will leave the chamber for 15 minutes.
Once again, the member for Finnis and his classy comments about the ladies. Madam Speaker, I would like an apology. That is outrageous. Why should any woman in this parliament stand here and be insulted by the member for Finnis again and again and again?
Now, there has been talk in Liberal circles for months that Mr. Pengelly could lose his pre-selection before the next election. Today's gaffe haven't done his chances any good at all. Back to you.